K-I-Z-Z-Y.
Oh!
Don't you never do nothing like that again. No reading, no writing. Never, ever. You hear me? White folks know a nigga can read and write. They see to it that nigga be worse than whipped. That nigga be sold.
Unchain your mind.
Yeah.
It's time. Unchain your mind.
Crisis Black.
Yeah.
We demand justice, and today I ask this: take control of the system we built and the people we employ, and be an amplifier for the voice of a group that never gets to be heard.
Shalom. My name is Brother Jacob Israel. Welcome to Unchain Your Mind. Tonight's class is Unchain Your Mind Now. So what we're going to talk about tonight is Thanksgiving, because you know the so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. Many of us celebrate Thanksgiving, which was the slaughter of our brothers and sisters, which was the Native American Indians. So I'm going to show you a couple of short videos, and then we're going to go over the scriptures, because we don't supposed to celebrate these pagan holidays. So I want you to watch these videos. We'll be right back, and then we're going to go over some scriptures.
Never forget.
Happy Thanksgiving, America. I'm Donna, and I'm here with my friends to tell you the real history behind this holiday. Growing up, I knew that what they told you in school about Thanksgiving wasn't true. That's not the true story. The true story behind Thanksgiving was, after every killing of a whole village, these European settlers celebrated it, and they called it Thanksgiving. But it wasn't until Abraham Lincoln became president that it became an official holiday.
He ordered 38 Dakota men to be hung for war crimes.
After the sacred holiday, Christmas.
We take this time to remember our elders who lost their lives due to what really happened. Usually my mom makes a Native American dish for us and we pray.
Growing up, I would be kind of annoyed that they didn't know what actually happened on Thanksgiving, and that they're actually celebrating the deaths of many people and many tribes that were lost.
Whether it's to give thanks or to be with your family, you should learn how the holiday was established in the first place.
I'm thankful for being born indigenous to this continent.
I'm thankful that I still have my culture.
I'm thankful that my elders kept our culture alive all these years.
I'm thankful to be indigenous, resilient, and alive.
I'm thankful for us all to be able to stand together, stand strong, and stand as one.
Happy Thanksgiving, America.
And I'm thankful for my kindergarten class who made these wonderful crafts to celebrate Thanksgiving.
After the Native Americans helped the Pilgrims survive their first winter in America, the Puritans invited them to share the first Thanksgiving.
Aww. Oh, these are adorably strong.
K-I-Z-Z-Y.
Oh! Don't you never do nothing like that again. No reading, no writing. Never, ever. You hear me? White folks know a nigger can read and write. They see to it that nigger be worse than whipped. That nigger be sold.
5-year-old made that.
Based off of the lies that you taught them.
Excuse me?
Oh, it's not your fault. These are full of half-truths and historical propaganda.
I thought the Native Americans and the Pilgrims were like besties or whatever.
At best, the Pilgrims and Wampanoags could be described as political allies. By the time the Pilgrims showed up, not only were 2/3 of the Massachusetts tribes completely wiped out by European slave owners and diseases, the Pilgrims were constantly at war with the indigenous people and routinely tortured them.
But what about Squanto, the Native American who learned English to help out the Pilgrims?
He was actually a slave that was hauled off to Europe, and then he learned English so that he could escape.
But they did celebrate it every year, right?
Not exactly. The next one was 16 years later, and unfortunately, it was because the Puritans were celebrating the massacre of the Pequot tribe. Back then, Thanksgiving was also for families, specifically murdering them.
Okay, we get it. History's awful. The Puritans were terrible. And now we have to let our children know that the holiday started with tons of killings. Happy?
Oh, who cares about how this stupid holiday got started anyway?
The food is really good. And if you ignore all the terrible history, like, you know, the murdering, the raping, the pillaging, it's still kind of a great holiday.
So the Mayflower is a lie.
Why do we eat cranberry sauce?
What about stuffing?
Is Black Friday really just a capitalist conspiracy to get poor people to buy things so we can't truly live out a populist revolt?
Or is it?
Are we even really in America?
Is this really
in
America?
And what about corn? I am never telling you the truth ever again.
As a Native American, what does Thanksgiving mean to me?
Loss of land, genocide, rape. I don't celebrate, you know, the arrival. I don't celebrate Plymouth Rock.
Thanksgiving, historically, is the murder of the entire village. Thanksgiving is not about Native Americans and Pilgrims eating peaceably together. That is not the history. My wife and I actually fast on that day in memory of those people. We don't eat anything.
I cook for the people that need to be cooked for to feed and empower and uplift other folks. Usually it's just a recommitting myself to activism, fighting, you know, the colonization.
As a Native American, you know, it's not easy. There are a lot of issues we face on a day-to-day basis. Either we are completely wise or we are uneducated savages.
They're using their political and financial power against indigenous peoples to take our land, to poison the earth, and to poison ultimately our people.
Never forget. Never forget. Show.
Hey, Shalom, welcome back. I hope you enjoyed those short videos. And now I just want to read an article, because like I said, every year our people, so-called Black, Hispanic, Native Americans, which are the biblical Israelites, choose to celebrate Thanksgiving, which originated by slave masters, right? And it was the slaughtering of our brothers and sisters, the Native Americans. But I'm going to read an article from the 6 Mile Post, right? And it's telling a little bit about the history, really what the Thanksgiving was all about. So I'm going to start with this article. Like so much of American history, the tradition telling of Thanksgiving was created to mask a dark past. So the dark past is that the natives were slaughtered, right? And the pilgrims that came, that they actually helped. They signed treaties and later on they butchered and slaughtered our people. But let's continue to read the article. Like so much of American history, the tradition telling of Thanksgiving was created to mask a dark past. Growing up, we learned the first Thanksgiving was a joyous feast between the Mayflower pilgrims and friendly local Native Americans. As kids, we blindly celebrated the holidays with classroom feasts and paper turkeys, only to later learn that the story of cultural acceptance we were fed was a lie. So many of our people, our children, were told that in the public schools that the Thanksgiving was just the pilgrims and the natives just coming together and just having a good time. But as it stated, it's a dark past. Thanksgiving has long disputed history. The most prevalent version tells of the 1621 feast where Plymouth pilgrims thanked the Wampanoag tribe for helping them survive in the New World, according to the time. The celebration lasted 3 days with deer, fowl, and corn on the menu. However, the pilgrims probably wouldn't have considered the 1621 Plymouth feast as the first Thanksgiving. The pilgrims actually felt a sober day of prayer in 1623 was the first Thanksgiving. Others viewed 1637 as the true origin of Thanksgiving when Massachusetts colony governor John Winthrop declared a day of Thanksgiving to celebrate colonial soldiers. However, this story doesn't sit quite the same, knowing that the same soldiers had previously slaughtered 700 Pequot men, women, and children in what is now Mystic, Connecticut. So the soldiers actually killed 700 of the Native American men, women, and children. All right, we're going to continue to read it. According to the historical contact, Indian people and colonists in today's northeastern United States, authorities in Plymouth began asserting control over most aspects of Wampanoag life as settlers increasingly ate up more land, writes Anna King, Business Insider. Settlers increasingly took up more land and disease had already reduced the Native American population in New England by as much as 90% from 1616 to 1619. No matter how welcoming the pilgrims were, there's no denying they caused the deaths of thousands of indigenous people. So as you can see, they murdered thousands of the natives. Massasoit, the Wampanoag paramount chief, called the Skamit proved to be an essential ally to the English settlers in the years following Plymouth's establishment. He set up an exclusive trade pact with the newcomers and aligned with them against the French and other local tribes like the Narragansetts and Massachusetts. Just one generation later, the alliance, that alliance was weakened beyond repair. So the white colonist settlers, they had an agenda, all right? Because they wanted to take the land and they wanted to destroy the Indians. So the only way they could destroy the Indians, as we're reading early in the article, they spread a disease as well as they killed many thousands and thousands of natives. Let's continue. By the time Massasoit's son, Metacomet, known to the English as King Philip, inherited leadership relations had dissolved, King Philip's war was sparked when several of Metacomet's men were executed for the murder of John Sazamon. Wampanoag warriors responded by embarking on a series of raids, and the New England Confederate of Colonies declared war in 1675. So as you can see, they declared war upon the natives. The neutral colony of Rhode Island and Providence plantations were eventually dragged into the fighting, as were other tribes nearby. The war was bloody and devastating. Springfield, Massachusetts went down in flames. The Wampanoag abducted colonists from ransomed English forces attached the Narragansetts on a bitter frozen swamp were harboring, fleeing one upon 600 Narragansetts were killed, and the tribe's winter stores were ruined. Colonists and far-flung settlements relocated to more fortified areas. Similarly, the Wampanoag and allied tribes were forced off their land and fled their villages. The colonists ultimately aligned with several tribes like the Mohegans and Pequots, despite initial reluctance from the Plymouth leadership. Meanwhile, Metacomet was dealt a harsh blow when he went to New York seeking allies. Instead, he was rejected and attacked by the Mohawks upon returning to his ancestral home at Mount Hope. He was shot and killed in the final battle. The son of the man who had sustained and celebrated with the Plymouth colony was then beheaded and dismembered. His remaining allies was either killed or sold into slavery in the West Indies. The colonists had King Philip's head on a spike and displayed it in Plymouth for 25 years. The war ultimate death toll could have been as high as 30% of the English population and half of the Native Americans in New England. So you can see they killed over half of the American Native Indians. All right? This war was just one of the brutal but faintly remembered early colony conflicts between Native Americans and colonists in New England, New York, and Virginia. The popular image of Thanksgiving is diluted, an altered version of the violent truth. By perpetuating a story of cultures coming together, we erase the struggles of indigenous people. So they erase the fact that they murdered and slaughtered the American natives. And they spread a disease like smallpox and killed thousands and thousands of the natives. So Thanksgiving is a bloody day, which is a day of celebration of what? White settlers destroying the natives and taking their land. For some, modern day Thanksgiving may be a celebration of people coming together, but to others, it is a painful rewrite of their history. So now we understand that Thanksgiving for our people, which are the Native American Indians from the tribes of Gad and Reuben, because they're the Israelites of the Bible, suffered at the hands of the colonies, which were Esau, the red so-called white man, and they destroyed them and they took the land. Even today, you still find our people on reservations. As you was watching in the videos, you also seen the fact that they was telling you that even today, they're still taking their land, they're still poisoning their land, and they also are trying to poison the natives because they consider them less than people, and the whole agenda was to take their land and to destroy their people. So we're going to go into the Bible, and we're going to explain, because the Native Americans are part of the 12 tribes of Israel, all right? They're God's chosen people. We're going to go to the book of Mark, chapter 7, and we're going to read verse 6 in the Word of God. He answered and said unto them, well, had Elijah prophesied of you hypocrites, as it is written. So we know Esau the rest of our white men. They tell our people to celebrate this day, but they're a bunch of hypocrites. Why? Because they slaughtered and murdered the Native American Indians. But our people, the so-called black and Hispanics, they celebrate and honor this day, knowing or not knowing that their brothers, the Native Americans, were slaughtered. And this day was a representation of a celebration of their slaughter. So let's read Mark chapter 7, verse 6 again. He answered and said unto them, well, had Elijah prophesied of your hypocrites, as it is written, these people honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. Because our people honor these days, as you can see now. Many of the so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, they're celebrating Thanksgiving. They're eating the turkey. They're eating the pie. They're eating the cranberry sauce. So they're honoring a day where their brothers and sisters were murdered. It's the dinner of death. All right? Let's read verse 7. The book of Mark, chapter 7, verse 7. Howbeit, in vain do they worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men. Because you have ministers in these churches that pass out turkeys in our communities and tell our people, have a happy Thanksgiving. Go home, eat your turkey, celebrate Thanksgiving. God said, howbeit, in vain do they worship me, teaching for doctrines and the commandments of men. Because they're not keeping the laws of God. And they're not worshiping God. They're serving Satan. So even in this American system where you see Christianity set up with these pastors that go around telling our people and teaching our people to honor these holidays and to celebrate these holidays like Thanksgiving, they're serving Satan. They're evil men. Verse 8, the book of Mark, chapter 7, verse 8. For laying aside the commandment of God, ye hold the tradition of men. What? Ye hold the tradition of men. Because this is the American tradition. The slaughter of the Native Americans, which are the Israelites of the Bible, of our brothers and sisters. This is an American tradition set up by the white settlers. Also set up by what? Abraham Lincoln. That made it into law to celebrate what? Thanksgiving. Let's read the book of Mark, chapter 7. Verse 8 again in the Word of God. For laying aside the commandment of God, ye hold the tradition of men, as the washing of pots and cups, and many other such things ye do. So, just like Thanksgiving, the Lord said, many of you so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans celebrate other traditions.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight.
That are given by men. Like what? Pagan Christmas, New Year's, Mother's Day, Father's Day, Valentine's Day. This is just another tradition set up by who? Esau, the red so-called white man, your slave master. But you set a table, and you eat a turkey, and you eat pies and cranberry sauce, and you celebrating the death of your brothers and sisters. Verse 9, the book of Mark, chapter 7, verse 9. And he said unto them, fool, will you reject the commandment of God? So that's what we say to our people. The so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. God said, do not follow the tradition of men. You reject the commandment of God? Let's read verse 9 again. The book of Mark, chapter 7, verse 9. And he said unto them, fool, well, ye reject the commandment of God, that ye may keep your own tradition? Because this is tradition that's given to you by your slave masters. Let's go to the book of Amos, chapter 5. And we're going to read verse 21 to 23. So, as you can see also in the video clip, you've seen the Black family sitting there, fools at the table, celebrating the death of their brothers and sisters, the American natives. But let's go to the book of Amos, chapter 5, verse 21. I despise your feast days. God said he hates Thanksgiving because Thanksgiving is from your slave masters. When they were sitting at the table, as you were watching in the video, why wasn't they celebrating slavery? Because the Native Americans was enslaved by the white settlers and sold into slavery. Let's read the book of Amos, chapter 5, verse 21. In the Word of God, I despise your feast days. So God despised all the feast days of America because that is the tradition of men, of your oppressor, of your slave masters, passed down to your slave master's children. And you decide to celebrate those days. God said he despised that and he despised you if you celebrate those days. Let's read verse 21 again. Book of Amos, chapter 5, verse 21. I hate, I despise your feast days. I will not smell in your solemn assemblies. Verse 22. Though ye offer me burnt offerings and your meat offerings, I will not accept them, neither will I regard the peace offerings of your fat beasts. So God said he will not accept any offerings of you disobeying his commandments. Let's read verse 23. Take thou away from me the noise of thy songs, for I will not hear the melody of thy vows.
No dessert yet, not until we do our talent show.
Oh no, if we have to sit through those children, I'm gonna need something stronger than this.
No, it's not the kids, it's air band.
Air band?
Because many of them that celebrate Thanksgiving, the day of death of our brothers and sisters, the Native Americans, the Israelites of the Bible, God said he don't want to hear the music you're playing. He don't care about the games that you're watching. He don't care about the melodies of your song. It's no celebration. It's a day of death, a day of slaughter, a celebration of slaughter for your people. And you, as being destroyed, trims your ways for your slave master's children. God said, he do not care about the noise of thy songs or the melody of thy vows. Let's go to the book of Isaiah. Jeremiah, chapter 2. Verse 33, the book of Jeremiah, chapter 2, verse 23. Why trimmest thou way to seek love? So why do the so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans on this day called Thanksgiving, which is a day of murder, a celebration of murder of the Native Americans, every year they succumb to this foolishness and they honor this day? God said in Jeremiah chapter 2, verse 33, why trimmest thy way to seek love? Therefore has thou also taught the wicked ones thy ways? Because do you not see the family with their children sitting there? Their sons and their daughters, their grandparents. They're inviting over their aunts and their uncles. And you're teaching nothing but wickedness. Why are you trimming your way for your slave master? That is tradition of men. It's a tradition that came from the same white settlers that also enslaved you, that also hung you, that also raped you, that also robbed you. God said, why? Why are you trimming your ways? Let's go to the book of Psalms, chapter 55, verse 20. So God said, don't trim your ways and celebrate these pagan holidays, because a judgment will come from God. And there will be death. Psalms chapter 55, verse 20. He had put forth his hands against such as be at peace. Because as I was reading the article, when the settlers first came, they came as if they was at peace with the Native Americans. And they showed them, the Native Indians showed them how to feed off the land, how to build, how to survive, and they pretended to come at peace, but yet they set up treaties, yet they destroyed them, yet they murdered them, and they robbed them, and they took their land, and they spread disease. But the white settlers came as if they came in peace, but they had another agenda. But let us read the book of Psalms, chapter 55, verse 20. He had put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him. He had broken his covenant. So Esau, the red so-called white man, these American settlers that came, they said, we want to be at peace with the natives. And they took advantage of them. And the natives were open to them, showed them how to hunt, showed them how to fish, show them how to survive in a place they knew not how to survive. So they came as if they were truly at peace. Let's read verse 21, the book of Psalms, chapter 55, verse 21, in the word of God. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, so they spoke kind and soft words. But war was in his heart. That's why I was reading of the slaughter of the thousands and thousands of natives that were murdered and killed and butchered by the white settlers, by Esau, the so-called white men, that destroyed them and took their land and fought against them and had them fight against one another. Verse 21, the words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. So war was in the settler's heart. War was in Esau the red so-called white man's heart to destroy. They came to destroy, to connive and to destroy. His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords. So let's read that verse again. The book of Psalms, chapter 55, verse 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war was in his heart. His words were softer than oil, yet were they drawn swords. So that's why all those wars started. That's why all those fights started. The soldiers came and they killed families. And all these treaties that were set up was broken. Why? Because war was always in their heart. Let's go to the book of Micah, chapter 2. And we're going to read verses 1 and 2. The book of Micah, chapter 2. And we're going to read verses 1 and 2. So, as our people continue to celebrate Thanksgiving, they're celebrating the day of death of their brothers and sisters, the Israelites of the Bible, which are the Native Americans. So our people are truly lost. Our people are truly destroyed. Our people are still listening to the smooth words of Esau the red so-called white man, their slave masters, and telling them, no, it's just a celebration, but it's a celebration of death. It's a celebration of death. The book of Micah, chapter 2, verse 1. Woe to them that devise iniquity and work evil upon their beds. So God said, woe to Esau, the so-called white man, that devise iniquity. It will be a judgment coming. And our people that continue to celebrate Thanksgiving and all these other traditional holidays will bear the same cross and judgment that Esau the red so-called white man would bear. And it is death. Because Romans 6:23 said the wages of sin is death. The book of Micah, chapter 2, verse 1. Woe to them that devise iniquity and work evil upon their beds. When the morning is light, they practice it, because it is in the power of their hand. Because when they came over, the settlers, the pilgrims came over, they had smooth words. And at night, they devised how they was going to what? Take the land from the natives, how they would go to war, how they would make these treaties, and how they would what? Turn and disregard every treaty that they would set up and agree with. It was an agreement, but it was deception. Verse 2, the book of Micah, chapter 2, verse 2. And they covered fields and take them by violence. So how was the Native Americans taking off their land? By violence, by murder, slaughter. Men, women, children, infants. They slaughtered the natives. But yet, many of you so-called Black, Hispanics, and Native Americans, which are the Israelites of the Bible, choose to celebrate the day of death. Shame on you. Shame on you. Because you're eating at the table that is representing the blood of your people, the blood of your brothers, the blood of your sisters, the blood of your family. Let's read verse 2 again, the book of Micah, chapter 2, verse 2. And they covered fields and take them by violence. So Esau, the red so-called white man, the pilgrims, the settlers, they took the natives' land by violence and houses and take them away. So they oppressed a man and his house, even a man and his heritage. So they oppressed them, the man and his house. They destroyed them. They put them on reservations. They gave them disease and famine. And yet you've seen, even in the small video clipping, even today, they're still poisoning the land and still destroying our brothers and sisters, the Native Americans. So if you're celebrating these holidays, if you're celebrating Thanksgiving, you so-called black and Hispanics, shame on you, because you will be judged. You will bear the burden of death. God said, follow not the tradition. Amen. Let's go to the book of Colossians, chapter 2. Verse 8 in the Word of God, the book of Colossians, chapter 2, verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit. So every year in November, they tell you, the so-called black, Hispanics, and Native Americans, to celebrate Thanksgiving. The philosophy is it was a day of welcome. It was a day of harmony and love. But it is a lie. God said, beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit. Because as I was reading in the article, it was slaughter and murder at the hands of Esau the red so-called white man, at the hand of the Pilgrim settlers. They came where the Native Americans dealt with them peacefully at first. Let's read verse 8 again, Colossians chapter 2, verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ. Because Thanksgiving is a rudiment of the world. Thanksgiving comes from your slave master. It's a day, as many traditional days, traditional holidays, that is set up by your slave master. All right, let's go to the book of Habakkuk, chapter 1. We're going to read verses 6 through 9. So do not follow traditions of Thanksgiving. Do not celebrate Thanksgiving. If you're celebrating Thanksgiving, shame on you, because God will bring forth judgment on you, the so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. Why? Because you're celebrating the death of your people. You're saying it's something to celebrate, and God said no. The book of Habakkuk, chapter 1, verse 6. For lo, I raise up the Chaldeans. Now, this is talking about the Chaldeans, but it's also talking about America. That bitter and hasty nation, because America is a bitter and hasty nation. They took away the Native American land with a bitter and hasty fashion, through murder, disease, and destruction. For lo, I raise up the Chaldeans, that bitter and hasty nation, which shall march through the breadth of the land to possess the dwelling places that are not theirs. And that's what they did to the Native Americans. They took over the land. They took the dwelling places that was not theirs. Let's read verse 7. The book of Habakkuk, chapter 1, verse 7. They are terrible. They are what? They are terrible and dreadful. Their judgment and their dignity shall proceed of themselves. Verse 8. Their horses also are swifter than the leopards and are more fierce than the evening wolves. And their horsemen shall spread themselves. Their horsemen shall come from far. Did the pilgrims come from far? Yes, they traveled over the waters. They traveled on boats. The Bible is a true book. They traveled far to that land. where the Native Americans was peaceful with them and showed them how to survive. Let's read verse 8 again, the book of Habakkuk, chapter 1, verse 8, in the word of God. Their horses, and they rode on horses, also are swifter than the leopards, and are more fierce than the evening wolves. And their horsemen shall spread themselves, and their horsemen shall come from far. They shall fly as the eagle that hasten to eat. So what is the symbol of America? The eagle. The American bald eagle. Let's go to the book of Nahum, chapter 3, verse 1, in the word of God. So our people, the so-called black, Hispanic, and Native American, God said, do not celebrate the traditional holidays of your slave master and your slave master's children. Nahum, chapter 3, verse 1. Woe to the bloody city. It is all full of lies and robbery. So as you sit at that table, you so-called black, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you sit at that table and it's full of lies. You're eating a turkey and it's full of lies. A pie and it's full of lies. It's not a celebration of harmony and love. It's a celebration of murder and death. And also your death. Because the same white settlers that took the land from the Native Americans, your sisters and brothers, also hung you and also took you from a land and also robbed you and spoiled you for you to sit there and celebrate that day. Surely God would bring forth judgment upon you. But God said what? In Nahum chapter 3 verse 1, woe to the bloody city. So he said, woe to America. So judgment will come. It is all full of lies and robbery. Because it was taken away by murder and theft. The prey departed not. Verse 2, the noise of the whip and the noise of the rattling of the wheels and of the prancing horses and of the jumping chariots. The horsemen lifted up both the bright sword and the glittering spear. And there's the multitude of slain and a great number of carcasses. And there is none end of their corpses. They stumble upon their corpses. Because when they was killing the Native Americans, they killed thousands and thousands. And as they was running away being slaughtered, they stumbled on the bodies of their fellow brothers and sisters. They stumbled on the bodies, the corpses of their family. So yes, the Bible is a true book. So as you hear that God said, do not celebrate these traditional holidays. Surely you must listen as the so-called black, Hispanic, Native American, because a judgment will come upon you. That's why tonight, class, this segment is called Unchain Your Mind Now. I'll repeat it again. Unchain your mind now. Let's go to the book of Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 29 in the word of God. So do not celebrate not only pagan Thanksgiving, which is a day that was created by your slave master, he saw the rest of all white men, but do not celebrate any other traditional holidays, for God will hold you accountable. For judgment will come not only upon your enemy, but it will also come upon you. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 33, verse 29. Happy art thou, O Israel, who is like unto thee, O people saved by the Lord, the shield of thy help, and who is the sword of thy excellence, and thy enemies shall be found liars unto thee, and thou shalt tread upon their high places. So, when Christ come back, he said your enemies should be found liars, and your enemies are being found liars right now. We're reading in the Holy Bible, the deceit of Esau, the rest of our enemies. We're reading. We showed you tonight in a short video. The natives are not fools. They know who took their land. They know their brothers and sisters, their family. You've seen the short clip. So why is many of the so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans confused or reject the fact that this is the murdering of their brothers and sisters? God will bring forth a judgment upon you. Because if you continue to celebrate days of death, surely death will come to you. Let's go to the book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 9. The book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 9. Because a lot of people may say, you know what? I'm not hearing what the Bible's saying. I don't care. I'm still going to eat my turkey. I'm still going to eat my pie, my cranberries. That's okay. God will judge you. There will be your death. Because it's a sin in the eyes of God. Proverbs chapter 28, verse 9. Because remember, you saw the little segment in the video, the fool's table, when one sister was saying the representation of what Thanksgiving really is murder of the Native Americans. The book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 9. He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, even his prayer, should be an abomination. So God said, do not follow the tradition of men. So when you're sitting at that table celebrating Thanksgiving, don't pray. It's a waste of time. God is going to bring forth a judgment upon you in your sin, which will be death. He don't hear you. So don't waste your prayer. Let's read it again. The book of Proverbs, chapter 28, verse 9. He that turneth away his ear from hearing the law, the commandment, the law, even his prayer should be an abomination. So don't waste your time praying at that table. You're celebrating Thanksgiving, you're celebrating your own death, your own judgment. Because God said, do not follow tradition of men. Let's go to the book of Proverbs, chapter 12, verse 15. So God said for the so-called Black, Hispanics, and Native Americans not to celebrate Thanksgiving. It is a day of death of your own people, the Native Americans, which are the Israelites of the Bible. The book of Proverbs, chapter 12, verse 15. The way of a fool is right in his own eyes.
In a time of great change, there is hope, but also ignorance and doubt. Imagine an endless ocean sea. More is hidden than revealed. More is unknown than known. And anything may lie beyond the horizon. Then one man named Christopher Columbus takes three small ships and sails into the sun to reach the riches of the Orient.
As a Native American, what does Thanksgiving mean to me?
Loss of land, genocide, rape. I don't celebrate, you know, the arrival. I don't celebrate Plymouth Rock.
Thanksgiving, historically, is the murder of the entire village. Thanksgiving is not about Native Americans and pilgrims eating peaceably together. That is not the history. My wife and I actually fast on that day in memory of those people. We don't eat anything.
I cook for the people that need to be cooked for, to feed and empower and uplift other folks. Usually it's just a recommitting myself to activism, fighting, you know, the colonization.
As a Native American, you know, it's not easy. There are a lot of issues we face on a day-to-day basis. Either we are completely wise or we are uneducated savages.
They're using their political and financial power against indigenous peoples to take our land, to poison the earth, and to poison ultimately our people.
Because a lot of you so-called Black, Hispanics, and Native Americans might say, well, we ain't celebrating that. We just eating it because, you know, our family gathered together. Then why are you picking the day that he saw the red so-called white man said for you to celebrate?
Thankful for my kindergarten class.
After the Native Americans helped the pilgrims survive their first winter in America, The Puritans invited them to share the first Thanksgiving.
Aww. Oh, these are adorably wrong.
A five-year-old made that.
Based off of the lies that you taught them.
Excuse me?
Oh, it's not your fault. These are full of half-truths and historical propaganda.
I thought the Native Americans and the Pilgrims were like besties or whatever.
At best, the Pilgrims and Wampanoags could be described as political allies. By the time the Pilgrims showed up, not only were two-thirds of the Massachusetts tribes completely wiped out by European slave owners and diseases, the Pilgrims were constantly at war with the indigenous people and routinely tortured them.
But what about Squanto, the Native American who learned English to help out the Pilgrims?
He was actually a slave that was hauled off to Europe, and then he learned English so that he could escape.
But they did celebrate it every year, right?
Not exactly. The next one was 16 years later, and unfortunately, it was because the Puritans were celebrating the massacre of the Pequot tribe. Back then, Thanksgiving was also for families, specifically murdering them.
Okay, we get it. History's awful. The Puritans were terrible. And now we have to let our children know that the holiday started with tons of killings. Happy?
Oh, who cares about how this stupid holiday got started anyway?
The food is really good. And if you ignore all the terrible history, like, you know, the murdering, the raping, the pillaging, it's still kind of a great holiday. Mm.
So the Mayflower is a lie.
Why do we eat cranberry sauce?
What about stuffing?
Is Black Friday really just a capitalist conspiracy to get poor people to buy things so we can't truly live out a populist revolt?
Or is it?
Are we even really in America?
Is this really America? And what about corn?
I am never telling you the truth ever again.
So that's a lie. And you a fool. But you might think you're right, but God said no. It's a judgment coming. Proverbs chapter 12, verse 15. The way of a fool is right in his own eyes. But he that hearken, he that listen to what God is saying. God is saying no. But he that hearken unto counsel is wise. The counsel is, what do God tell you to do? God said no. He said, do not celebrate no traditional holidays of men. Because we have our holidays, which belong to us, which is from God. Which are holy days to us because we're God's chosen people. But yet, many of our people will follow the tradition of their slave masters and their slave masters' children. Let's go to the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 31. So, today's class is, do not sit at the table of death. Do not sit at the table of death. The book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 31. Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his ways. So if you're sitting at that table, Thanksgiving table, you so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, and you eat turkey and pie and cranberries, if you're sitting at that table, you have choose to love your oppressor. You have choose to love death. So don't cry when you're dying in the streets at the hands of your oppressor, Esau, the rest of the white man. Don't die. Don't cry. Don't waste your time crying because you're in love with your oppressor. You envy the fact that he gave you this day to celebrate. You saying it's okay, even though he destroyed your brothers and sisters, which is the Native Americans. But if you're in agreement with that, then don't march. Don't cry. Don't complain. You're okay with it. You're just fine with it. Let's read verse 31 again. The book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 31. In the word of God. Envy thou not the oppressor, and choose none of his ways. So don't choose to sit at the table of death of the murdering of the Native Americans, which are the Israelites in the Bible, you so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. When the same white settlers hung and put the yoke of iron around your neck and murdered you. So, truly, you are a fool if you do that. Let's read verse 32, the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verse 32. For the fraud is an abomination, because how can you sit there and eat turkey and pie and cranberries knowing that the same man that killed and murdered and took the land of the Native Americans is the same people that murdered and killed and stole you from your land. It's a fraud of man. It's an abomination to the Lord. For the fraud is an abomination to the Lord. But the secret is with the righteous. And the secret is, God is telling us in the Bible, do not follow tradition. Do not celebrate Thanksgiving. Do not envy your oppressor. Your oppressor destroyed you. What is it to envy the man that destroyed you? Let's read verse 33. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 33. The curse of the Lord is in the house of the wicked. Because, remember, judgment is coming to America. These sort of so-called white men. Judgment. They're receiving a judgment now with the plague of COVID-19. See everybody walking around with a mask on their face? That's a judgment from God. And more judgment is coming. Thus saith the Lord. Let's read verse 33 again. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 33. The curse of the Lord is in the house of the wicked. And America is a wicked place. It's a wicked nation. But he blessed the habitation of the just. And we are the just when we obey God and keep the commandments of God. All right? Let us go to the book of Luke, chapter 16, verse 13. Because as we see our people to continue to celebrate these traditional holidays, and as God bring forth judgment upon that people, they still believe they're in a godly state, but they're serving Satan. You're actually serving Satan. You're not serving God. Luke chapter 16, verse 13, in the word of God, no servant can serve two masters.
This church opening its hearts and doors to the community for the holidays with a hot home-cooked Thanksgiving meal. The church established over 100 years ago and began serving the community more than 20 years ago.
The church serves the community by giving clothing, food, and other resources to those in need. Today, dozens showed up for a hot cooked meal.
We have done this every year for almost 20 years, particularly for the holidays and Thanksgiving. We want to let the community know to come by, share with us on a hot, warm meal as we share our heart with the community. We usually average about 300 to 400 meals every time we do this during this time of the year. So we have plenty of food. It's great. It's home cooking at its best from the heart of the church.
For details on the church and their services, you can visit our website, WT.
So that's why I said, why are you praying at that table? You're not serving God. You're serving your slave master. So why are you eating that turkey? You praying at the table and you singing songs and you dancing and you, it's a good old time. That's death. You're celebrating your own death. You're celebrating your own oppression. But you're not serving God. No servant can serve two masters because God said no. But you do it anyway. So you're serving Satan. You're serving your slave master. Luke chapter 16, verse 13. No servant can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and man. So when you celebrate Thanksgiving, you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, you showing that you hate God, that you hate the law, statutes, and commandments. So, let's go to the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verse 11. We almost finished. Because God said, do not celebrate Thanksgiving. Do not celebrate traditional holidays that are given to you by your slave master or your slave master's children, which is Esau, the red so-called white man. Because you're walking around with his last names from the plantations. You're not confused. God has made it clear. And God said in 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 33, he's not the author of confusion. The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verse 11. We're about to wrap it up. Envy not the glory of a sinner. So God said, do not envy America. Do not envy Thanksgiving. There's no glory in eating at the table of death. Of your death, of your brothers and sisters, the Native Americans, which are the Israelites of the Bible, you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. God said, envy not the glory of a sinner. So do not envy Esau, the so-called white man. Do not envy America. Judgment is coming to America. envy not the glory of a sinner, for thou knowest not what shall be his end. Because his end is going to be death, judgment from God. Let's read verse 12. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 12. Delight not in the thing that the ungodly had pleasure in, because Esau, the red so-called white man, he set up Thanksgiving. He has pleasure in that, the turkey. He benefited from that. He took the land from the natives. He murdered the natives. He set up that day. He has delight in that. What delight do the so-called black, Hispanics, and Native Americans? The one that he hung on a tree and put a chain around his neck, the yoke of iron, and whipped his name into him, has pleasure in celebrating the day that he set up, that he destroyed your brothers and your sisters. God said, what? The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verse 12. Delight not in the thing that the ungodly had pleasure in, but remember, they shall not go and punish. What? They shall not go and punish into their grave. It's a judgment coming. So that celebration of death, eating that turkey, eating that pie and that cranberry sauce, you end up dying right along with your oppressor that hates you. He has no problem with your death. The meal that you're eating is because of death. Let's read verse 13. We almost done. The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verse 13, in the word of God. This is what God said. Keep thee far from the man that had the power to kill. Don't eat at the table and celebrate death of the Native Americans. The Israelites of the Bible, you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, don't celebrate that, because the same death that was brought upon him was brought upon you. So God said in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verse 13, keep thee far from the man that had the power to kill. So shalt thou not doubt the fear of death. And if thou come unto him, make no fault, lest he take away thy life presently. Remember that thou goest in the midst of snares. And remember, he set up snares for you, traps to destroy you. And that thou walkest upon the battlements of the city. That's why you see our people being destroyed in the cities, suffering in the cities. So, I just wanted to have a short class on this segment tonight. Unchain your mind now, so our people may not continue to celebrate this bloody day of Thanksgiving, the day of slaughter of our brothers and sisters, the Native Americans, as our Native American brothers and sisters, as well as us as people, continue to be abused and oppressed and destroyed and suffering here in America. We want our people to turn back and keep the commandments of God. Let's go to the book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 19, because we want our people to turn back and realize who they are as the Israelites of the Bible, that we are God's chosen people, but we must repent and acknowledge our sin. We must acknowledge that we've been celebrating these traditional holidays, which is of our slave master, which are at the hands of the people that destroy us. And God do not want us to celebrate our death, our destruction. The book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 19, in the word of God. Repent ye therefore and be converted. So God wants us to change. God wants us to stop. That's why tonight class is unchain your mind now. God wants us to stop. And I'm going to bring more segments like this, because I just want to address issues where our people have to think, just stop. That's why you're going to see short segments of unchain your mind, unchain your mind now. Because we want our people to think and understand. God is saying we need to do that now, as God bring forth these plagues and judgment upon America. He's bringing these judgments upon us, so we understand what's going on in our life. We understand what's going on around us. Alright? Acts chapter 3, verse 19. Repent ye therefore and be converted. So God wants us to change, that your sins may be blotted out, that you will remember not to continue in sin, that God can blot out those sins, because you're not going to continue to what? Celebrate these pagan traditional holidays like Thanksgiving, Christmas, Mother's Day, Father's Day, 4th of July, Veterans Day, these days that came from your slave master, George Washington's birthday, all these days, you have no reason to partake in those. So God wants you to be converted, to change, to not continue to do that. Let's read verse 19 again from the top. Repent ye therefore and be converted, that your sins may be blotted out, when the times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. So when the refreshing time comes, the judgment that God will bring. All right, let's go to the book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 7. The book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 7. We're almost finished. Hope you enjoyed this class. We're going to bring more classes, the Lord's will, on the new segment, which is Unchain Your Mind Now. Because we need to repent and stop what we're doing now. Because remember, the judgment of God is like, the Lord is like a thief in the night. We don't know when our judgment is coming. The book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 7. The law of the Lord is perfect. So that's how we're going to be perfect in the eyes of the Lord. It's simply by just keeping the commandments. The Lord said, don't celebrate traditional holidays like Thanksgiving, which is the day of death, you know. The dunner of death, you know. Because you're eating that, and you're celebrating that which is unprofitable, all right? And that's just to our own destruction, all right? So, the book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 7, again, the law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. So that's what's going to change us. When we're keeping God's laws, that's what's going to convert us to what? Doing what God wants us to do as his people, as his chosen people, as the Israelites of the Bible, all right? The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. So the testimony is here. We just went into the Bible. We just read of Micah 2 and 1. The testimony is there, what was done to our people and who did it to our people. So now all we have to do is obey the commandments of God. Verse 8, the statutes. What are statutes? The laws. The statutes of the Lord are right, and it's right, because it belongs to us, you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. We are his chosen people. In Deuteronomy 7 and 6, he said a holy people unto himself. We are to be holy. What makes us holy? Keeping the commandments of God. Keeping the law, statutes, and commandments of God. The book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 8. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing in the heart. And that's what we should be rejoicing. When we're keeping the laws of God, not the celebration, Thanksgiving, death of Esau, the so-called white man, the murdering of our family, the Native Americans, which are also the Israelites in the Bible, that's nothing to rejoice in. You should be ashamed of that. You should be hurt. You should say, no, I will not partake in that. Let's read verse 8 again. The book of Psalms, chapter 19, verse 8. The statutes of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandment, the what? The commandment, the what? The commandment of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. Verse 9, the fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The judgments of the Lord are true and righteous altogether. Because God will judge us. Brothers and sisters, God will judge us. So-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, do not continue celebrating Thanksgiving. It's a day of murdering and destroying of our people, the Native Americans. And our people are still dying today at the hands of Esau, the so-called white man. But it's written in the Holy Bible. He is playing his part. And we have to do what we need to do. Remember, we're in the hands of our enemy. God said for us to turn back and keep the commandments of God. So, like always, on the Chain Your Mind, in the night segment, and Chain Your Mind Now, it's not a competition, it's just a mission that I can bring out the word of God that our people may seek repentance. And like always, I like to say, all praises the Most High, Shalom, Most High Christ bless.
Never forget. Show.